Turning now to the coronavirus pandemic, last week's ice storm left more than 240,000 people without power across the Memphis region.
Yeah, it forced many to leave their homes and take shelter elsewhere until the power was restored. WRG's Jordan James is live with how that decision, interestingly, could impact the number of COVID cases. And how could that be, Jordan?
Hey, Greg, that ice storm came at a time where COVID cases were starting to decline across Shelby County. One doctor I spoke with believes it could have an impact, but just how much? Well, that remains to be seen. As the winter storm moved across the Mid-South, hundreds of thousands were left without power. Some have endured the elements over the last week, while others sought shelter elsewhere.
Man, it's been hard on me. Real hard. I mean, it's hard on everybody really around here and everything. Yeah. I had to go to my friend's house, Mr. Cherry, and stay there for like 2 or 3 days.
It's a decision that could impact our healthcare system, given that we are still in a pandemic and the coronavirus continues to spread.
Anything that causes people to congregate indoors without great ventilation, as you're not going to have great ventilation indoors in the very cold weather, that's going to be an impetus for increased viral transmission.
Currently, Shelby County is averaging 501 cases a day over the last week, which is the lowest it's been since December. With the ice storm forcing people to congregate, Dr. Stephen Threckhill believes we could see a slight increase in coronavirus cases.
Whether we'll see a blip in the actual numbers that then translates into further hospitalizations, I'm hopeful that that won't happen because the phenomenon you're talking about is happening on the tail end of this surge.
If the winter storm forced you out of your home, Dr. Threckhill recommends you get tested for the virus and continue to wear a mask.
It's helpful if you're shifting the group of people you're going to be around after being closely confined with a different group. It would be helpful to test when you come back into your other setting. And if you think you might have been exposed, certainly to repeat that test after 24 to 48 hours.
Even with cases going down across the country, Dr. Threckhill says now is not the time to let your guard down. Reporting here live downtown, Jordan James, WREG, News Channel 3.